on the working session, the only thing I don't see on there is discussion of the substitute pay. Can we add that to the working session? Where do you wanna do that? Because I know these folks are here for that. You wanna go right off the top before we get to the policy or the board committees? Or you wanna wait? Wanna put it under citizens forum? We do that without Jeff and Norm? I got my microphone on too, that's it. But I wanted to make sure that when my microphone was on, I pointed out the test for any commissioners. It was cold, it was dirty, it was muddy, but I wasn't gonna let you get off the hook. I mean, if your kids are home watching you and wondering why you're not in hockey, you're the only sane one. Like I guess as long as we're discussing it, Jeff's about getting a crib sheet. Anybody want to make a comment or discussion topic about the arena? That was the first half hour of our. Right, I think hopefully it's an easy process, and I get that sense, like you said, there was sort of that glossy, waxy look to it, so that's something different. I didn't ask Mike that, but, I mean, schedule finishes February 9th, right? Was it now in the March? Because I know there was a February 9th date at one point. But either way, next spring.
So will there be any, there won't be any hockey games there?
I heard that Colonel Anderson was going to do a show on ice kind of thing. Various outfits and whatnot. Well, anyway, I was impressed with the speed that goes up, and Boyd pointed that out. The concrete construction just boom, 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 boom. It's just unbelievable how fast that is. All right, anything else? We're done. No, we're just talking about the arena. You got a comment on it, feel free, but just trying to see what the world's thinking. We added substitute teacher rate to the working session and a discussion of that. So we put it right next to the citizens forum. Jeff, Cindy, you okay with that? Sub rate, it's right on the working session we're going to talk about. We'll prove it or not, whatever, before we get to the business. Okay, as long as we're going, we might as well get right there then. Next item up for discussion, number two, substitute teacher rate in the citizens forum. Unless there's another citizens forum topic I'm ignoring. You guys are obviously here for the summary. Okay. I'll just throw it out there. We talked about it last meeting. We've got the, yes, Chris will go around and look at the various rates. I think Roseville is the only one in sort of the five or six districts adjacent to us, that was about 135. Everybody else was either at what we are or lower. And there was discussion about it not being a budgeted item as of yet. So that certainly could pose a little bit of an issue. And anybody have a thought on it?
No, we haven't had any other group. Regardless of what the other districts are doing around us, it's time, and it needs to be enough to be, everybody's going to have it. And I think everybody around. gotten for at least that, if not more. Regardless of what the other districts are doing, last time we raised ours, they raised theirs shortly after. Rose was down above us by $10, they're at $135. When we set the rates 10 years ago, they had to based on a percentage of the big names. We were at that time 75% of the big names. We're not near that at this point.
That was the counterpoint to the argument. And while I wholeheartedly agree we need to get, needed to get rid of the $85 a day if you're less than 60 days, again, we're tied with the second highest. So I guess I was looking at a more moderate increase rather than going quite as much a share, simply because, again, that's, you know, need to be in the highest. You'd like to be, but everything costs money. And if we approach everything with that rationale, yeah, we'd price ourselves out very quickly. I mean, I'd love to give everybody a raise, janitors, bus drivers, teachers, everyone, but...
They all
have to. Okay. Okay, I'll go. My point in our committee meeting then was that tells me that 10 years ago, we must have been way higher than everybody else if we were still, again, getting rid of that $85 a day initial idea. But if we were at $125 10 years ago, and now we're still the second highest in the area, that tells me that we must have been either way high last time or nobody's raised theirs. I don't know if we can answer that question specifically, but I guess that's my rationale for maybe a moderate increase, but not quite as big one as you're in this proposal. We can do whatever we want. Everything's relative, and what we call respectful. I know from the committee meeting that you and I have different concepts of respectful.
It's your respect.
We both respectful with each other.
Discuss.
Is anybody, before we get into that, is anybody going to defend the position of keeping a 60-day
no, that's
grace period? Everybody know what we're talking about. So
get rid of it.
Okay. So, I mean, that's passed.
Yeah. Yeah, no matter what we decide, that part's gone. So the 60-day thing.
And then not to sound like I'm pandering, I'd like to just point out that we got really good subs. And I'm not just saying that. You know, I think that if there's a real quality in there that we want to continue with, we don't necessarily want nothing to happen when the primary teacher's gone. I mean, I think that we only get 180 days of education. We better make everyone worth the while. So I see that as another pertinent point to, and we are getting teaching staff that is just now, you know, coming into the retirement mode, and it's nice to keep them coming back into the program. So I think those people are obviously pretty good at it, and you know, know the kids as well as possible.
Yes, they have to be safe.
Yeah,
they
have
to be safe.
And that's not up for discussion at the moment. This is strictly noted.
This is strictly a short call.
So from an administrative...
You know, I the 135 is great. I mean, that's the $10 day increase over $1 an hour more. I would like to see about 140 just because I don't feel we're pricing ourselves out of the market at that. I don't feel Rosa's a larger community and they have more to draw from. At 140, that will pull them this way versus them going to Rosa if they're on the fence about whether to come here. It's for this for them to drive. It after 10 years, if you look at what's possible to do better, I mean, I'm coming, and I know you said we have to compromise. That is my compromise. That started with that. So, to me, that is an out of my head. And that is just, that's what I feel like. You know, I believe, even though Rose was at 135, I believe.
That's next year. Further discussion. I don't think that we're not making a decision here.
No.
I mean, I think you have the right to go ahead and say 140. And I think I walked into this room with that same thought, that I just didn't want to keep revisiting it. But it would be nice to have a policy that demands me to do that as opposed to letting it get 10 years out of it. 4 years, no matter where we end up.
I think you definitely want to revisit it because, again, this is one of the arguments that, I mean, it's a supply and demand issue. I mean, if the supply of subs moves to the point where you're getting desperate, well, guess what? Prices have to go up. I mean, that's the nature of it.
Reactionary versus proactive.
Well, yes and no, but I mean, it's the same thing. I mean, yeah, you can be a little bit proactive on it, but how proactive do you want to be? I mean, you kick it up to 150, you can say you're being proactive, but that may go another 10 years, and then everyone else catches up with you. And you may or may not get subs anything.
that would have made it 147.
Yeah.
That was 75. Oh, that's right. It was 139 and then round 139.70. Well, if you decide we want to make policy of that, that would be something for future discussion. But I guess for the moment, what we're looking at is what we want to put in there for this year. So.
Yeah, I was just adding that about the basis.
You've heard us throw these around. You were around last, you said 20 years ago, you guys decided on a situation.
Visited every couple of years, and you don't have to be astronomical. It doesn't, you know. Right.
It's not as hoping to raise a $3
or
$5.
Right. It's not as hoping to raise the cost, you know, raise the cost of the game or raise the cost, you know, the cost of the return.
And soon the last year, you know, you need that.
We're going to revisit it a year. I guess I'd be inclined to go with 130, which is still an increase and would put us strongly at the second place in the area without creating, kind of the way you described it 10 years ago or 20 years ago, whenever it was, you created this bidding war where everybody went up and everyone was chasing each other to try and get this out. Maybe that's what's needed. But I think 130 next year, for this year, would be good because we're going to be revisiting. We can easily go up again. There's no reason not to tier it, and it would be a 4% increase. So, I mean, it's not too bad, I don't think. So, I guess that's kind of what I was thinking.
Well, we have it on the table there, and I just... certainly make motions when we get to regular sessions in terms of amounts or not. But I think we're all in agreement. Up at some, just just a question of how much, like, I like the idea, like you said, let's revisit it either. Not necessarily the policy, but at least put in the writing that you're going to revisit. All right, I'm going to move on if somebody else wants to keep going on that. The other thing that we lacked in there, do you want to talk about your contract for your working session? There's a clause in the regular meeting to approve your contract. You want to read that? Talk about that. Okay. All right, thank you. If you want to get through committees, you want to just start the meeting.
We can do it either way.
It all takes the same amount of time. Let's get the committees now. You want to do your stuff right now before we get into the meeting? Because it's going to put you back on halfway. Well, why don't you go ahead and do it? And that'll get, because we're going to be here no matter what.
Yeah.
Why don't you talk about girl hockey?
Okay, girl hockey. I originally, before I got here today, I looked at it and didn't think we had one registered participant. So we did not get the 5 required, so we will not be going to call for international calls. On that same subject, I have had a conversation with War Road and asked them to open some dialogue with their coach. I haven't had any feedback on that. So any questions on the girls' hockey?
At the moment, I mean, something on that could happen in September. Could we revisit if we had to with War Road?
Yeah, you co-op just has to be in place 1 month before the first day of practice. So we have until approximately the middle of October.
Okay.
Yes. Yeah. We wouldn't supply a coach. We wouldn't do any of that. They would be getting their a lot like how Rainy River does with us. We would just be a participant in the co-op, not an active participant. Looked at some numbers and met as committees. It could cost as much as $400 a night extra if the coaches don't drive at times when needed. So you do that 13 times during a season, and that adds up pretty quick to a budget that we just don't have.
And it could go even higher than that, too. That's one thing we discussed in the committee is, it could be a much higher than that, depending on how far it is and that sort of thing.
There was nothing in writing as far as job descriptions for coaches. So this is as far as we Lake of the Woods goes, this is a new document for coaches having an actual job description with expectations.
I appreciate the specificity. And we think document about the digest. It looks like a ton. You look at it and say, that seems like a sense. But it's in, I mean, it's in writing. This is what you do with the used to call for. This is when you, how you discipline the player. This is where you go.
And I found that that stuff, why there is a lot of information, especially new coaches and even some veteran coaches, need to have that there because even they just don't know sometimes what to do with this, where to go with it. This way they'll have a document that they can refer to. And if I've got questions, I can refer them to that document also.
And I guess for a question I had too after reading through it, and it's very good, are we going to allow coaches to be more restrictive or change anything in that document? I'm just thinking like some of the transportation things.
Just like any other handbook, it's going to be reviewed yearly now.
Yeah. But is that going to be all sports? Like the hockey coach says, well, I'm going to make this more restrictive. And,
it would have to be a group decision.
Okay.
And not just an individual. It would be myself meeting with the head coach is more likely to review the handbook, and they can make suggestions. Once again, those will just be suggestions that I can take to the board or
okay. Yeah.
As time goes on,
yeah,
we'll find some
yeah.
things will change. Things are going to change.
Yeah.
And we'll have the ability to make those changes when we need to.
I just think the reason why I brought that up is a couple of years ago, I forget which sport, you had the general meeting, and then you broke out into the specific sport, and something totally different was said. And it's like, didn't they just say that this was the policy? And I
exactly. We want consistency.
Any further questions? Okay, thank you, Coop.
And then the last thing is the update on fall sports. We have 101 registered participants. There's possibly up to 27 football players, 45 to 46 volleyball players, and then the rest will be cross country, 12, 14 cross country. Our numbers are pretty good. The online registration went well. I only had a handful of people that needed to come in and pay with a check or cash. That worked pretty well. All of everything said, we collected over $10,500 in fees before the first day of practice. So.
Mm-hmm. Nice. All right. Anything else? Okay, how many kids are in potentially out of 101? I mean, is that a percent accurate?
For what?
That are participating, that would be eligible for age 74. Do you know what that number is? Is it 50%?
Eligible for.
You mean how many kids are eligible for this? You know, fall sport, how many actually do it?
I don't know what our total enrollment is. What is our
So
about 45% of our student body is participating in fall activity.
That's really well.
Yeah.
I don't have exact
numbers. Good participation numbers.
Okay, anything else? Thank you. All right, without further ado, let's get the regular meetings. Nobody needs to pray.
Okay. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic of the States, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
All right, we're going to put the board committees under board presenters. Thank you.
agenda additions, I still have a question about your contract, because you're going to be in the consent agenda, but do you want to remove that so we can discuss it? That would seem to be appropriate, wouldn't it?
Because that can be discussed in closed session, is that what you're saying, or what?
I don't know if we necessarily need to discuss it in closed session, but if you, I mean, if I go through the consent agenda, we're approving his contract with no input from board discussion. The evaluation will be in closed session at the end of this, you know, the contract itself. If it's going to be part of the regular board meeting and the approval, right now it's going under the consent agenda. And you've all had a chance to see it, but it seems to me with all five of us, we should have a chance to publicly discuss it, shouldn't we?
Yeah.
So should we just remove that and put it just past there somewhere? And let's put it, we're going to put it as AA, just right at the top of things here. Okay. You're looking at me somewhat askance. I mean, is that not what you expected? I mean, I think you have a whole thing. Somebody who's promoting, so I feel like we need more than necessary for them.
That is the whole point of the session.
Okay. Otherwise, in terms of changes, the agenda with the additions under personnel, having appointment desk role as a paraprofessional, and written communications, add the emergency leadership program letter. And under new business, we're going to add now the superintendent's contract. And approve the resolution for the use of procurement cards and the approval of the coaches' handbook. Oh, and approval of the ASME MOUs for Diane Lane, Crystal Olson, CC Charlton, and Greg Cole.
And the addition of board of directors.
Oh, same thing. Okay, and board communications, the board of committees. Okay. Thank you, Sharon. Ellis and Feldman. All right. All those are any further discussion? All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, same sign. Motion carries unanimously. Okay. Now for the approval of the consent agenda, which is inclusive of the agenda, the minutes of the prior meeting, the invoices, personnel resignations, Tori Sindelier and Chris Perfume. Okay, so just cross it out. Appointments of Diane Lane as the Martin Assessment Coordinator, Tracy Cook as the Media Center Office Secretary, Melinda Castillo as a paraprofessional, Jessica Grohl as a paraprofessional, and the superintendent's going to remove the approval of maternity leave request from Laura Ramon, and the approval of AFME MOUs for Diane Lane, Crystal Olson, CC Charlton, and Brent Cole. Motion, make that agenda or the consent agenda.
I'll make the motion.
Motion for three. Gentlemen, any further discussion? All those in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, same sign. There's unanimously. Okay. Already on to board presenters. We want to do board committees. Right off the bat, we have policy committee.
The crisis.
really in depth. I mean, it was got to you guys that much in depth?
Oh, yeah.
Pretty
good. It took a few hours to go through that meeting.
Okay, the finance committee just met for the arena tour.
We have a new report. We'll see through the needs all understandable. We discussed the new auditors and we discussed some things.
Yeah, considerably.
We just did that.
This was the light version.
And the auditor report, I could ask questions on, I didn't understand the answer. You have changed over, right?
Yes.
Daily.
I
did. Transportation Committee.
REITs are kind of the push for the lease concept is REITs concerned about the our average bus age is now approaching 10 years old. And when, I forgot when he had it, say 10 years ago, it was 4 years old. So now you get more concerned with catastrophic breakdowns.
That just was a, that's what they have. so long.
Yeah. Yeah.
I was curious about that. What's the logic?
Just to try one.
Yes.
The life of the month is not that much different. I'm like, you talk about, you know, we talk about cars or 300,000 miles to live on the car. You know, and save the house or you need 300,000 miles. At least it's a lot. A lot longer life.
That's the, he wants it mainly for impound, because the problem with diesel buses, they're not warm enough for impound, and with the death fluid and the regen rates and stuff, they don't get on the highway, so they don't get heated up and burn off and start to feel it. Well, then they go into this regeneration mode. Now you're in limp mode for 20 minutes and sitting there. So he wants to try a gas bus, primarily for the impound, but saying they've improved in efficiency and durability and everything with the gas, so.
And the initial cost of diesel is going to be way more than
you. Yep, the initial, and that was one of his points too, is that it's more expensive. So he wants to primarily try it for the in-town route, just to get around that tier 4 diesel requirements.
You don't have to worry about it selling up on the way from Gas Lake to that.
Yeah, well.
Going along at 4.5 miles an hour, just to get me story.
The whole world probably doesn't.
Yeah.